Welcome students. Students, today we'll be doing two theorems, theorem 6.8 and theorem 6.9. Theorem 6.8 is Pythagoras theorem and theorem 6.9 is converse of Pythagoras theorem. Exercise 6.5 is based on these two theorems. So we will be doing these theorems and then we can do exercise 6.5. Theorem 6.8, which is Pythagoras theorem, it states that in a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of the other two sides. This is a very famous theorem. You know it here. We are going to prove it. We are given a right triangle. Say it is ABC right angled at angle D. And we have to prove that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Here AC is hypotenuse and AB and BC are other two sides. To prove this, we need to draw BD perpendicular on AC, and this is construction. Here we have drawn BD perpendicular on AC. Now to prove this theorem, we'll be taking triangle ABC and triangle ADB. Both these triangles are right triangles, right angled at B and D respectively. Therefore angle ABC of triangle ABC is 90 degree and angle ADB of triangle ADB is 90 degree as well. Therefore these two angles are equal and are corresponding angles. Also angle VAC of triangle ABC, this angle VAC, and DAV, this angle DAV of triangle ADB, these two angles are common. Therefore triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB by AA criterion. Similarly, we can prove that triangle VDC is similar to triangle ABC, as we proved triangle ABC similar to triangle ADB. Similarly, we can prove that triangle ABC is similar to triangle VDC, because this angle ABC and angle VDC both are 90 degree, and angle BCA is equal to angle DCB, because this is common angle BCA, this angle, and DCB again this angle. We have taken equation number 2 similarly. From equation number 1 and equation number 2, we will be driving equation number 3 and equation number 4. First of all, let us see how we have taken this equation number 3. In equation number 1, triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB. Therefore, corresponding sides of these two triangles should be proportional, which means AB upon AD should be equal to AC upon AB. Here we have to keep in mind that in this equation we have to take AB twice, so that we get AB square equal to AC into AD. From this equation, in next step we will get AB square equal to AC into AD, because this AB, when we will shifting it to left side, it will give us AB square, and this AD after going to the right side will give us AC into AD. This is equation number 3. And in equation number 4, we should have BC twice. How we have to take BC twice? First of all, VC upon DC is equal to AC upon VC. We have taken VC twice, and when we shift this VC to the left side, it will give us VC square, and in the right side we will be getting AC into DC. These are equation number 3 and equation number 4. After equation number 4, we will be adding equation number 3 and equation number 4. In the left side we get AB square plus BC square, and in the right side we would have AC into AD plus AC into DC, this equation. And here AC is common, so in bracket we will get AD plus DC. Now AD plus DC is AC. We can see it from the diagram. AD plus DC, this is AD and this is DC, so these both together make AC, and AC into AC, AC square, therefore we get AC square is equal to AB square plus VC square. This is to be proved in this way. We have proved theorem which is known as Pythagoras theorem. Now we will be doing converse of Pythagoras theorem. It states that in a triangle, if square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides, then the angle opposite to the first side is a right angle. Here we are given a triangle in which AC square is equal to AB square plus VC square. We have given this triangle name ourselves as ABC, and if this is triangle ABC, then AC square is given to be equal to the sum of squares of AB and VC, and we have to prove that angle B is 90 degree. In Pythagoras theorem, we are given a right triangle and we need to prove AC square equal to AB square plus VC square. Here we are given that AC square is equal to AB square plus VC square. We need to prove that angle B equal to 90 degree. Let's say this figure. In this figure, AC square is equal to AB square plus VC square. It is given, and we have to prove that this angle B is right angle. To prove this, we need to construct another triangle PQR. This is triangle PQR and it is right angled at Q, such that we have drawn QP equal to VA and QR equal to VC. This is in construction, means we have drawn this ourselves. This is not given. We have construct this triangle to prove the theorem. Here PQ is equal to AB and QR is equal to BC. Also angle Q is right angle. Now in triangle PQR, this is a right triangle, therefore by Pythagoras theorem, PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square. This is by Pythagoras theorem, and in construction we have AB equal to PQ and BC equal to QR. Therefore this PQ square can be written as AB square and this QR square can be written as VC square, thus AB equal to PQ and BC equal to QR. This is question number 3. Now we will compare question number 3 and question number 1. Here right sides of these questions are same, AB square plus BC square, here also AB square plus BC square, therefore we get left sides equal, means AC square equal to PR square, and this square will cancel this square and we will get AC equal to PR. This is question number 4. Now we take triangle ABC and triangle PQR. These two triangles are congruent because AB equal to PQ. This is question number 1. AB and PQ are corresponding. Also BC equal to QR. These are also corresponding sides of these two triangles, and this we get from question number 2. And AC is corresponding to PR, and these are also equal from question number 4. Therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by triple S criterion of congruency. It means angle V is equal to angle Q, because congruent triangles are having equal angles, corresponding angles are equal in congruent triangles. Means this is by CPCT, congruent parts of corresponding parts of congruent triangles are always equal, and angle V corresponds to angle Q. Now angle Q is 90 degree. This is from construction, because we have drawn triangle PQR right angled at Q, means angle Q is 90 degree, and if angle Q is 90 degree, then we get angle V equal to 90 degree, and this is to be proved. Hence proved. This way we have to do this theorem number 6.9. Okay.